honest, this is not how I thought this was gonna go. I was so excited to try this product.
Put it back up, bring it down.
Greetings and salutations, everybody. Hey girl, hey! It is the morning, I'm Raspy, and we're going through some ColourPop releases today. More specifically, their new Pretty Fresh line. We have the tinted moisturizer, we have the setting spray, we have the primer, and all of these products feature hyaluronic acid, which is a very popular hydrating ingredient, and we're gonna see what happens. Just a reminder on my skin type, I'm a medium skin tone, yellow undertone, oily T-zone, drier, pore-ish, textury mouth area. I like to call that combo. And that's what we're working with today. Let's get started with the Pretty Fresh Hydrating Primer. It doesn't say to shake well, it's not making any noise, so we're just gonna start prepping this pump. All of the products are dermatologist tested, gluten-free, paraben-free, and vegan, but more specifically, the primer has no silicones in it, and the setting spray and the tinted moisturizer do not have any oils. They are oil-free. There also is no silicone in the tinted moisturizer, so mainly the only thing that does have silicone is the setting spray. Long story short, I do have the whole shade range and some extra fair tone shades. Originally, I was sent 4 fair shades, but today I'm going to be swatching the 4 medium skin tone shades, 9 through 12. Packaging-wise, you have a soft squeeze tube, a lid, and a pump. Something a lot of people have noticed in the shade range would be that none of the shades have the letter C. All the shades either have an N for neutral or a W for warm. I don't know the reasoning for this. Here are the 4 medium shades, 9, 10, 11, and 12. This is 9W, 10N, 11N, and 12W. So let's swatch on my face. 9W, 10N, 11N, and 12W. Originally, I was leaning 12W, and I'm still kind of thinking that it might just apply lighter than it sets, which wouldn't be uncommon. But in my opinion, from all the swatches I've seen publicized online, especially on ColourPop's website, I think all of the shades are actually lighter than the swatches, but that's just me. I think a tinted moisturizer consistency is really hard to swatch because when the pigments are packed together, they look completely different, if you know what I mean. Like when it's blended out, whole different shade. The neutrals aren't it for me. I could make 10 neutral work, but I'm considering either 12 or 9. 12 just looks really light. Props to me for remembering to not swatch on the prime side this time. Hallelujah. Claims to be ideal for all skin types, features hyaluronic acid for hydration, and then coconut water that is supposed to help with softness. They are selling a sponge to go with this formulation. I was not sent the sponge, so I'm just gonna use my usual Morphe one, which seems like a similar consistency. And we're gonna try 12W. I saw some comments under the initial release post about the coconut ingredient, but the argument was that coconut oil is clogging, but coconut water is nourishing. We'll see what happens. I don't know. I don't know if I've ever had a reaction to products that have coconut in it, but take that how you will if you do know that coconut is an irritant for you. 12W. It just looks like my face, doesn't it? I think we got a match, twinsies. Keep in mind, this is a lighter finish, lighter coverage, tinted moisturizer. This is not a foundation. It's looking good, though. It does have a very nice, like, I just moisturized finish while giving me just a little bit more evenness, as you can see from the side that has nothing on it. That was about a pump and a half on this side of the face. So I'm going to take my velvet sponge and see if we can make this product go a longer way with this type of consistency. Do not use a velvet sponge. It's leaving imprints in the formula, so it's just not compatible. Let's try a brush as well. Just blend quickly. Brush is actually leaving streaks, so a sponge is really the best bet, or your fingers. I don't see anything wrong with the finish from the Morphe sponge, so I'm just gonna keep using that. It is sticking better to the prime side. I think the prime side already looks a little bit more smooth. Oh no. It is not applying well to my texture area at all. I'm gonna bring you guys into a close-up cam, but I think you guys can see from even there, it is big mad on that side. It's a little better on the prime side because it's probably smoothing it over. This is ColourPop's 3rd foundation release. They released it under the Pretty Fresh line. They have a bunch of kind of sublines, a 4th Ray Beauty for skincare, and then soul for like body. A lot of people are asking why they're separating things. I don't know, maybe it's just by aesthetic, but they're all available on ColourPop.com, and I do have a code for it. I get no kickback from it or anything like that, but if you need to use a code, 5SAMAGE is down below, but certain products don't apply. I don't actually know the details. I think it just depends on if it's a fresh release or not. I'll leave it down in the info box if you need it. But back to referencing the other reviews, I did try out their stick foundation. I have a separate video, and I tried their liquid. I was a fan of the liquid foundation more than the stick, and I think currently this is my least favorite of the three, just because it's really not doing anything for me. It's okay on this side. Like right now, the prime side, not too bad. I feel bad for the not prime side compared to like, oh, like it's just less fat. I actually wouldn't want to wear it in this state.
Try to use my hand and just cover up some of the craziness.
That didn't work at all. Now I'm in debate if I should just mix in some primer right there because it's just gonna look crazy all day, or just leave it. It's not sticking at all on the textured spot, so maybe just a little bit of the primer here because I can see my bare skin and just little flakes of foundation trying to hang on. Not foundation, tinted moisturizer. It's not really much better either, so we're just gonna have to move on and finish the rest of our makeup. I am gonna use the ColourPop concealer for my under eyes. This is in shade medium 24. I'm gonna wipe whatever residue I have left on my sponge from my under eyes just across my lid so my lids aren't apparently darker. I wasn't gonna go for anything too crazy makeup wise stick. I feel like tinted moisturizer is more like light and, you know, airy. Some of my scars are just looking really crazy, so I'm gonna conceal the scars around my mouth. I have broken blood vessels, according to my dermatologist, just over here, but I'll leave the other ones that aren't just right next to my mouth out for you guys to be able to see the coverage. I was using the Flower Beauty Light Illusion Full Coverage Concealer. This is in shade light medium, my favorite for, you know, just skin tone concealing. I don't have one for the under eye shades. Currently only available on Amazon because they're moving from Walmart to Ulta supposedly, so you're not gonna find them at Walmart, but you can't find them at Ulta yet. But Amazon, they do sell through for $10. For powder, I'm gonna use the No Filter Banana shade. It's, per usual, a mess. Any of my powders that don't have a filter will just end up looking crazy. Don't make fun of me. I'm gonna set where I just concealed, and of course my very oily area, so just kind of surrounding my brows, between my brows and my nose. The finish of the tinted moisturizer has calmed down quite a bit. I mean, it still feels like something, but it isn't super shiny and it's not super unnatural. So I'm not gonna powder anymore. I don't think it's gonna help. This chin is just tragedy right now. I'm looking a little ashy though. So this is usually when I would set my face after concealer and powder. I set a little bit right now, or a lot of it. And then I set when my face is finally done. So we're gonna prep this ColourPop spray. The packaging is simple, but it's a very like sturdy packaging. You can't squish the bottle. The spray feels actually like nice. It doesn't spit at you. It sprays pretty consistently. It has a really fresh scent. It's not super coconutty, but I feel like I can get a hint of coconut from it. We're just gonna apply this all over our face because I really don't think the condition of the not prime side is doing well, so maybe this can save it. Claims you can use it after makeup or throughout the day as a refreshing spray. While our spray dries and sets, I can tell that maybe like 50 to 60% of that ashiness on my face is now gone. That has dissolved, which is great. It's looking a little bit more true to color, a little bit more, you know, like skin-like compared to ghostly. That little ghost cast, I don't want that on my face for sure. But any areas that we're having like kind of issues with, those are still there, sadly. But overall, I think we look maybe 50% better. My face is tingling right now though. I don't know how I feel about this. Tingling, like in like a prickly way, all over my face, like on my eyelids, my cheek, my forehead, and I'm resisting the urge to touch it. But let's just hope things don't go completely wrong. Worst case is that it breaks me out and I have to finish my wear test early, but I'm gonna try to keep this on my face all day. I need to finish up my hair, the eyes, the cheeks, the lips, and all of that will be on my Instagram. Since we did so many up-close cam sessions during this application, I'm gonna leave you guys with some starting point pictures before I see you at the end of thy day. We're back. It is almost 9 o'clock at night. 9 hours. This is gonna have to be it today, guys. I just came from hanging out outside in the humidity, the East Coast humidity, with the neighbors. They're having like a little block party situation. So my face has been out for like 2 straight hours in the humidity, and otherwise, you know, normal wear, normal errands, normal lunch plans, etc. But I just saw everything up close, and while I just kind of collect my thoughts, I'm gonna throw the pictures up on the screen that I just took. Aside from the humidity getting my face, it also got my hair. Let's talk about my feelings chronologically. So when I first put this on, as you guys saw in my impressions, I would have given this a grade of a D minus just off the bat. I did not enjoy the formulation. I didn't enjoy how it was applying and slightly not applying. I wasn't enjoying how it sat on my problematic areas. Really just wasn't impressing me in many categories at all, aside from maybe just packaging. So as time moved on, let's skip forward maybe 2 or 3 hours, my face was having a minor reaction, and that might be a personal problem, but I could see just little bumps, you know, on my forehead, little bumps on my cheeks, almost just like a little allergic reaction. It has calmed down a little bit, but my face was pretty uncomfortable during those maybe hour or so where I was like, oh my god, like I just want to scratch it off of my face. It's very uncomfortable. Definitely wasn't lightweight to me because I was so aware that it was on my face from its reaction. And even without the reaction, I can still feel it on my face. It's not that comfortable. That's always a big thing for me, comfortability. And then, of course, how does it wear? My chin right now is cracking, and I'll give you guys an up-close clip. My nose earlier looked very flaky and peely. The clip I'm showing you guys is from the beginning of our wear test, like before starting point picture. For something that claims to be hydrating, that one of the two claims it has, one being lightweight, one being hydrating, I don't think it's either of those things. I'm oily skinned. I don't need a lot of hydration compared to someone who's dry skin. Of course, I do have drier spots, but it's not impressing me on any part of my face. I do look worse than it probably would on someone who doesn't have really dark pigmentation spots like I have. Scarring on my face, some from lasering and such like that, fresh little blood vessels or whatever have you. I know that I'm not gonna look flawless with this type of product. It's not supposed to be high coverage, and I'm cool with that. But if you're not gonna be high coverage and you're not gonna last a long time, you could at least be comfortable and hydrating. That's just my personal perspective. I understand that it is affordable. It is $14, but there are other drugstore price ranges that I would rather spend $14 on. If you haven't seen my review on the NYX Bare With Me Tinted Skin Veil, this is a really great option. Someone asked me to compare these two, and I by far would pick this for every reason I stated in that video, and obviously you just heard my thoughts. I will say that it does look better now than it did maybe 4 hours ago, maybe mid-wear test. It was probably at its worst. Now that I've been out in the humidity and my oils are really coming out in my face, it does look a lot smoother right here than it did before, but it is also kind of fading off my nose now because I can feel the dampness coming, and it doesn't look great. The only areas that look okay right now is literally just right here, just the front of the cheekbone. The forehead doesn't look good, the chin doesn't look good, the nose doesn't look good, and for that reason I'm going to give it a letter grade of a D. I took the minus away, and I feel really bad because I do not like giving products negative reviews, but that's just my experience. It just didn't live up to any of its hype or claims to me. If I looked like this in the beginning of the wear test, rather than drier and, you know, more struggle bust, I would have gave this a C overall, but there's no way anything about this would get anything higher than a B, and the B would be in packaging. Packaging and price. Primer performance helped with the application, as you saw, but didn't change anything when it came to wear. It looks exactly the same on both sides. Setting spray wise, we sprayed the whole face, and I think that's the only reason any of it is still on. So this may work. I don't think it really hydrated that much. I don't think it's also that special. The mist itself is very nice, and the packaging is also nice. So I'm not gonna grade this badly. I think this is like a B minus setting spray, while the primer I'm just gonna give a C. I might be crazy, but to me I see a little flashback in the pictures as well. Might be minor, but it's reacting more than I thought it would for something that doesn't advertise that it has sunscreen in it. To be honest, this is not how I thought this was gonna go. I was so excited to try this product. It was just one of those products that make me look worse now that I put it on compared to just going out without it. Sorry, ColourPop. I know y'all probably watching this, and I feel bad. I appreciate you guys sending me new releases, and I hope you guys don't take this too personally. It's just not the best formulation in my opinion, but I am just one person, so take that how you will, everybody. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing my opinion. I know this wasn't the result anyone wanted to hear, but it is the result we have. That is it for me today. My recent uploads will be here for your clicking enjoyment. You can also click that subscribe button down below if you haven't subscribed yet and joined our fam. I am sweating bullets, so I gotta go, guys. I'll see you in a later video.